Hi everyone, and welcome to the presentation of the Impact Accelerator 4 Infrastructure Management Tool. This Impact Accelerator 4 is about a network simulator, and not only this, it's a network simulator that in which we are going to work with implications on the risk and criticality assessment of the, specifically of the BT network infrastructure. My name is Manuel Herrera, but it's not only my work, this is a collaboration with Jani Preselkov, Ajith Parlikat, and other colleagues at the Institute for Manufacturing at the University of Cambridge. But just to start, we're just going to present that what this network is about. And this network specifically is the network we have in the left side of this slide, in which in red, we observe the core and metro network. And in black, we observe the metro access network of BT in Great Britain. What I'm saying here, we are just going to focus only in the core and metro network. The nodes of the network is are representing the router stations. So no, I'm going to mention there are routers only, but there are router stations or big points of presence or data centers, etc., that BT has split in this country. The links, of course, are just cables, not only one single cable, but probably some aggregation of different cables to connecting these different router stations or points of presence of BT. But the objectives of this work are basically, as we expected by the name of this network simulator tool, the objectives are the analysis of the network dynamics to understand the data traffic and to understand how topological changes may affect it. And ultimately, we can use this network simulator tool for develop some what-if analysis that is going to be very interesting for the risk modeling and assessment of the network, because when through this what-if, we can just estimate well the impact of the anomalies that already happened, but also the impact of those anomalies that didn't happen yet. So we can just have a better level of preparedness of just to improve or level of resilience in the network. On top of this, we are going to analyze this network from the point of view of network of networks, because we are going to take into account the redundant topology of the BT infrastructure. What is this redundant topology? Is that in the BT infrastructure, all the assets we have, they are just duplicated. So at the end of the day, we are going to have the double of elements we observe here in the split in the spatially distributed in the geography of the country. We are going to have the double of them, and this is going to be very interesting because we're going to avoid overloads in the data traffic, and it's going to add a protection of the network, and some other consequences we are going to analyze later on. But speaking of this redundant topology, we observe here on the left side the single topology that split with the nodes classified in red, orange in the core network, and in green in the metro network. And then on the right side of this slide, we have the same topology, but in the version in which all the nodes are mirrored. So what could happen is that every single node has the counterpart in the other network. But let me insist that the data traffic is not redundant. The data is single and is just split in these two networks, just to more efficiently reach the destination to that of the packets are having. But if we just work in the single topology, just to make the things slightly easier by the moment. We observe that a single topology, they have a scale-free topology in the sense of analysis of complex networks. This scale-free topology is made up by a ring topology in the middle that we observe that is made by regional routers, but out of the regional routers, they appeared some lollipops connections to metro routers, that some of them, they are also interconnected between themselves. So globally, what we have here is the well-known scale-free topology of complex networks. But if we take the other, on the right side, the other network slice, the network slice composed by the super and regular routers, so the inner core network, what we call it, that we observe that they have a different topology, is closer to a small world topology in which all the nodes are almost interconnected to each other. And then we observe here also that we are working only with one single network. When we are adding up the redundant topology, this messed interconnection in the inner core of the BT infrastructure is going to be even higher. So it is, we see that these are a lot of protection and redundancy that we have in this part. So basically, this is one of the reasons why most of the work on the anomalies and the traffic possible failures is going to be focused on the outer core network that is more prone to have some issues. But these anomalies, how are detected? The anomalies are detected through a process called graph Fourier time series mining. Basically, what we are doing is that the graph signal taken or computed every 2 minutes for several days with real data. So the graph signal is just transformed by a graph Fourier transformation, and then we are going to have some kind of spectrum per each of the time steps of the time series of these days. We are going to make the study, and we are going next to concatenate this spectrum of the graph per each of the time stamps, and finally, we make with all this a very long sequences of data, which can be understood as a time series of small sequences of graph Fourier transforms. So with all these long time series, what we are doing next is just to extract patterns of the most repeated patterns or the discourse we observe in the time series by the algorithm, a process that called matrix profile. In this slide, we observe here marked in red those discourse. Those discourse are just in coincidence, for instance, with this node. We can just get the spectrum of the graph Fourier transform when the discord happens, and now of it we can just estimate which are the nodes that they have more influence in that discord, so we can just obtain when the discord happen in the nodes of the network. So basically, is we observe here, for instance, node 44 is having more issues. And if we just check carefully the node 44, we observe that this discord is actually an anomaly in the data traffic time series. And then when this happens, what actually happened is that the time series is not just behave as expected, but is going to have some ups and downs, adding a lot of variability, and is not going to be stable. So it's going to stabilize later on when the failure is finished, the time of this discord finishes. So the idea is just to replicate this anomaly in the network simulator, right? So this is the anomaly again, and then over the outer core network topology, we just detect which is the node 44 involved in this anomaly, and this is the node, famous node, where the anomaly happened. And what happened is when we just replicate this failure multiple times, is that in average we observe this the overloaded nodes, how they behave in this network. And this is the queue formation in general. Queue formation is the data packets just waiting to be attended in each of the nodes. In comparison, we have the same failure again happen in the node 44 and also the node 44 mirrored in the redundant topology. And we compute the same, the overloaded nodes and the queue formation again. We already observe here that the queue formation is a bit slow formation when we have the redundant topology, right? If we just observe this different characteristic. If we just run the simulation and we observe the output of the simulation, we see here that the traffic evolution is marked in a color code at the links, and the node congestion is going to be in relation with the node size. It's proportional to the congestion at the nodes, to the queue made at the nodes. What we have from here, this is the failure happen, and this is the failure happen in the redundant topology. In comparison of these two topologies, we see that the impact of the failure in the single topology is higher, is quicker, how the failure can spread and not only affect the node in which the failure is happening, but it's going to affect other parts of the network very quickly, because the traffic need to be redirected to other parts of the network to reach the destination. While in the redundant topology, even when the failure is happening, the impact of the failure is going to be noticed, but in a very slow manner, right? So basically, this is what we observe here, and we observe one of the benefits of having this redundant topology for the network, but also we just have a way in which we can just compute this impact of the network. And if we don't only replicate this failure here, but we replicate the failure in any other node, we basically can create a kind of map of risk over the network. If we go a bit in more in detail about when the failure happened, we observe here in the single topology how these the queues are just made more quickly than in the redundant topology. That is also something that we already mentioned before. So we see here how the queues are just basically sharp going up to the threshold level of the queue length we established before for the simulation, while in the redundant topology their nodes are going to be are going to reach this threshold of attendance, but in a slower manner. Just to go a bit into detail about how this network simulator is made. The network simulator, the main of the network simulator, is made by nodes and links. The structure of these nodes is something like that. There are incoming connections that we coming with the packets that are arriving are just queuing here to be attended, and then once they are attended, they are just forwarded by the shortest path to the destination. Basically, that's it. There is another probability in which the packets are just dropped as well. So this is the scheme of a node, but the nodes basically they are going to have these characteristics. So the packet rate in which they just send or create new traffic, they have a parameter to of delay, they have a parameter just computing the adding the time of they stay just checking each of the packets they receive. And also we have the queue cutoff. When we reach this queue cutoff, then supposedly the probability of the packet drops is higher, or even one. And the links, they have some transmission delay over them, and link capacity, just to avoid problems of overload of the links. We also need to mention here some of the good properties of this network simulator. The first is the scalability. We observe we could just work with the network simulator, not only with the core metro network, but also with the redundant version of it. So this is a double of nodes and links. But we could also work with the metro access network if we wanted, because we can just work up to thousands of nodes, and we can just run this in a standard computer. So it's very interesting. We added the capability to work with group of nodes of different parameter values. We observe here that this node is node N0, but we can create another node N1, and then this other N1 may represent different characteristics of other router station we have. And also the links vary depending on the type of nodes they are connecting. So this is the link connecting N0 to N0 nodes. But if it's connected to one node that is N0 to one node that is N1, the link parameters might vary. In this network simulator, we just adapted the shortest path to increase traffic to certain nodes that may represent some key router stations in the network. And we also model the disruption of the degradation events on the fly. So when we just saw before the failure happened, the failure already was programmed that should happen. So we didn't need to stop the simulation, make the failure and run it again. The failure happened on the fly. And this happened in a programmed way, but we can implement this failure happening in a probabilistic way depending on some of the parameters of degradation of the system. So just to mention that this simulation is based on discrete event simulation and made in Python. And we see here some Python code, by the way, and in which we observe that, for instance, some details of how we can just work with the import of the network elements. So we just need to add edges and the nodes of the network, and we need to write them in this way. We can just try to import them also at some point, just to make this easier. But basically that's it. Once we have the topology and the type of nodes, then the rest is straightforward. We just load some util packages, load the parameters of the network, and then run the simulation over the time period we want to run it, and just save the results in some folder. The results are just saved in some specific folder we have, and then we have the output by in the screen of all these characteristics that may be helpful to see if everything was correct in the simulation or it wasn't. So just to wrap up, let's repeat that this network simulator is going to inform decisions at different business levels and time scales, and it's going to help network managers in the development of an optimal decision making. This is important because it is interrelated with impact accelerator 2 and 3 in regard to the data traffic, topological change, and the analysis of advantages and disadvantages of the redundant network topology. But also this network management tool is useful as well for risk modeling and criticality and resilience, that is linked to the impact accelerator 9 and 10. We can just work with a probabilistic impact assessment of the anomalies, those anomalies that already happened, but we can get a deeper understanding analysis of those anomalies, but by the repetition of the anomalies under slightly different conditions, or just the mere repetition, because they probabilistically they may impact differently to the network. But also we can just analyze these anomalies that didn't happen yet but may happen in the future, and then we can bring a set of anticipated disruption scenarios to the further risk assessment. In consequence, we can improve the resilience, we are supporting the near real-time decision making, and also we are supporting the risk and governance of the network and the BT infrastructure. And that's it. Thank you very much for your attention, and I'm happy to respond any question you have. Thank you.